morning class. In today's lecture, we will start the next topic of unit number 4, and that is a text summarization. So we already see that in this unit is very interesting, and it is really more application oriented concept we will learn in this unit, that is a text information extraction, then the text summarization and the text classification. Okay, so number of applications you can develop using these three steps or three concepts, that is a text information extraction, text summarization and the text classification. So in this text information extraction, you have to extract the information from the website or any resources, okay, and keep it in an unstructured format. That is unstructured format. And once you extract the all information online from this particular URL, okay, so once you find out this URL, find the information, so the information is, okay, you have stored it in the unstructured format, and once you get that in unstructured information, then apply the summarization, summary of your paragraph that we are also covering in our practical. Okay, so let us consider it has a 1000 lines. Now you have to summarize it into the 100 lines or 50 lines. Okay, so now your document is like look like this. So from this side, your summary will be 100 lines. Okay, and after that, you can classify your data. Okay, so let us consider this data is more related to the sport, or you can say that it is a theme. It is a more related to the sport related data. It is more related to the finance. Okay, it is more related to the traveling. Okay, it is more related to the education. So first type of information you can categorize or classify. Okay, this is your third step. So using this huge amount of information nowadays available in on the internet, that may be in the text format, mostly the information available in a text format or video format or audio format. Okay, AV data. So these are the different types of data is now data is available on internet, but extracting this information, summarizing this information and classifying this information is very serious stuff. Okay, and it is most important nowadays, right? So on this basis you can find out the various classifications, you can classify your data, and according to that you can tell your data to the customer, your businessman. Okay, so here the dollar is come. Okay, so from this stage you can tell this data to any company, for example FB or Instagram, okay, yeah, Amazon, yeah, Flipkart. Okay, so there are n number of business platform available where you can sell your data. Okay, if it is a finance related data, so you can sell this data to the HDFC bank, you can sell this data to the ICICI bank. SBI is not interested because they already have the billion of customers. Okay, so HDFC bank is very much interested. Who are more interested? They are more interested in the finance domain data. Okay, the sports related data is also required by the BCCI. Okay, or other sport activities. Education data now. All of you know that. What is the current situation of Baiju? Right. Okay. So Baiju is one of the top platform in the education sector. Okay, so how they earn their money or how they grow their business because of this data. Okay, so that's why nowadays it is called as a data is an oil. Just like your petrol price are get increasing, so after a few days you can see that this data is also get sale and this data's information, data's prices also get high. Right? So in this way, these three steps only, 1, 2, 3, these are the major steps, major method you can say that in an NLP for the text. You can also apply this to the video or audio. Okay, you can say that audio summarization, you can say that the audio classification. Audio classification is a finger class, finger audio, okay, male, female, then the other types of audio you can classify, right? Baby boy, baby girl, right? So according to that you can classify the voice also. So the n number of application you can develop by using this simple three steps, that is information extraction, text summarization and the text classification. So in the last lecture we have seen the how we can perform the text classification and various applications and from where we can extract the data in the information extraction process. So now today we will see the text summarization. So what is the text summarization? The text summarization refers to the technique of shortening the long piece of text. Okay, so what is the main aim behind this text summarization? The main aim behind this text summarization is shorten the long piece of data. Okay, so this data is also useful. Okay, you have to make a proper summary of 1000 pages into the one or two pages. So in that case you require the some intelligence, you require the some machine learning approach, you require the some deep learning approach, okay, to summarize this text data into the short term. The intention is to create the coherent and the fluent summary having only the main points outlined in the document. Okay, so instead of going to whole document because of the shortened time, so lots of people are not interested to read whole article. Okay, what they are interested, they have to just read out this information here. Okay, the summary of the paragraph, and once they find out, okay, this summary is good, then and then they can move ahead and read the whole page. Okay, so in newspaper also you can see that there is a section, that is the section of each story. Okay, you have to just read out that story summary, and if you find out if the summary is good, then and then you can go further read this whole news or paper. Okay, so that is the more main point. You have to just highlight the main point here from this whole page, and that is very challenging, and this is a you can say that this is called as a text summarization. So machine learning experts say that the technique has provided the critical in quickly and accurately summarize the voluminous text. Okay, so here we accurately summarize means your accuracy is required more in the summarizing this whole text. Okay, because you are picking up only the main points, you are picking only the those keyword points that are more important while you are reading this data, okay, so this is called as a, this is the concept behind the text summarization. Okay, something which could expensive and time consuming is done without the machine. Okay, right, without the machine, if you want to try to make a summarization of your data, okay, or summarizing your articles, so it may be take some time. Okay, so instead of that, what we are doing, mostly it is useful in the case of that where the documentation are most important. Okay, so in the banking sector or in the law and in the other sector where the documentation are very widely used, so in that case this text summarization play an important role to make a short term piece of data very quickly and accurately. Okay, so they have to sum up this data very quickly and accurately from this voluminous text. Okay, so there are a few definitions of this text summarization. The text summarization is the text summarization Text summarization is the process of distilling the most important information from the source to produce the abridged version of the particular user or the user and the task. Okay, so in this case, we are next first most important information. We are concentrating on only the most important information from that document. Okay, so sometimes you also seen in the news, that is the breaking news. So in that breaking news, they are just giving the some keyword. Okay, they are not telling you in the breaking news flash. You may heard the breaking news. Okay, so in this breaking news, they are just giving the keyword. See, Sachin done his century. Okay, so this is just headline, but the total whole document or whole news after that. Okay, so the breaking, in the breaking news, there may be a one line or maximum extent to two lines only. Okay, so in the one or two lines, you have to do the summary of that particular document, and for that you require the most important information, and from that the most important information. Okay, so this text summarization in this case, you have to find out the most important keyword, and from that keyword you have to generate the sentence also. Okay, the ideal of automatic summarization work is to develop the technique by which the machine can generate the summary that successfully imitate the summaries generated by the human being. So just like the human beings, your machine has been also successfully imitated the summary of that particular text document. Automatic text summarization is the task of producing the cosine and the fluent summary while reserving the key information content and overall meaning. So in this summarization, it is not allowed to, you have to change the meaning also. Okay, no, you have to concentrate on the meaning also. Okay, the text meaning or that sentence meaning, you have to keep the information meaning as it is. Okay, and also presenting the key information. What are the key information we available in that particular paragraph, and also the overall content of that particular task, particular document. Okay, so you are not change the theme of that particular document. You have to keep the theme of the document, as well as you have to find out the key information from that document. So what are the stages we have to use in the text summarization? So there are the four stages we are basically used to summarize your data or summarize your information. Okay, so these are the main stages we have to use for the text summarization. So the first one is called as a content selection. Okay, we will see in detail each and everything. Okay, in the second, information ordering. Then the third, sentence realization, and fourth, that is a removing the redundancy. Okay, let us see one by one now. Okay, the first stage, obviously, that is the content selection. What is the content selection? In a content selection, you have to choose the sentence to extract from the document. Okay, so in this 1000 line statement, so let us consider there are the 1000 line statement. Got it? So choose the sentence to extract from the document. So which statement is more important, or which keyword is more important from this sentence of 1000 line, you have to select it. Okay, so according to that, you have to give the weightage or the weight to that particular line or particular sentence. Okay, so we will see in coming lecture, that is a page ranking also. So in the page ranking, you can get an idea about all these things, right? So this statement is important in this 1000 line. This statement is important in this line, in this 1000 line, this keyword is important. Okay, this keyword is important. So according to that, you have to find the content. Okay, and you have to extract that content from your document. Then once you extracting the data or sentences from the document, the next task is to information ordering. Okay, but why? Because when you extract the data, that data is nothing but the unstructured format. Unstructured. Okay, it is also called as unstructured database. Nowadays, it is also important topic to convert the unstructured data into the structured database. Right. So here you are getting a data and that is unstructured. Means let us consider here I am taking the keyword like Sachin Tendulkar. Okay, these are the few. Sachin Tendulkar, okay. Then the test match. Playing fabulous 100. So these are the unstructured. So you have to make a proper wording. Then you have to place the grammar also. Okay, and then you have to generate the one sentence that Sachin Tendulkar on his 10th match he had to play a well match, a fabulous match against the Australia. Like this, right? So you have to make a proper ordering of that sentence also, that keyword also. Okay. So information ordering, that is the second stage. Then sentence realization. Simplify the sentence. Don't make the sentence complicated. It may happen because you are just extracting the data and putting the sentence one by one. So in this case, the sentence may be get complicated. Okay. So your task is to simplify your sentence also. Okay. So sentence simplification is also one of the next tasks, that is the sentence realization and removing the redundancy. So redundancy means repetition. So sometime in 1000 lines there may be some sentence that are redundant. Okay. So in that case you have to remove that redundant sentences. In that case you have to also remove the redundant sentences from your summary. Okay. And using this four steps, you can easily perform the text summarization. Now, for the first stage, that is a content selection, there is a one method called as the Lund method or the proposed in 1958. See, the era where we are living now in 2020, but the algorithm, that all the algorithms we are used in the machine learning, in the deep learning, in the natural language processing, that already has defined, okay, 50 years back or 70 years back. Okay, so according to this method, choose a sentence that have a silent or informative word only. Okay, so from this sentence, I am going to office. Okay. So from this, you have to choose the sentence that have a silent and informative information. Which information you are getting? So someone is going to, let us consider here, Sachin is going to office. So let us consider what information you are getting. So someone is going to office. Going office. This is information you are getting. So instead of writing whole word, you have to find out the information. So this is your information. Going office. Okay, so these are the informative words. These are the informative words, that is going, office, for example. Okay, so these are the informative words you are getting from the sentence, and that is called the imputation. Now, there are the two approaches to define the silent word from your sentence. Okay. First is called the TF-IDF method. We will see in the next slide graph what is the TF-IDF method. Okay. So, what is the TF-IDF method? So, in a TF-IDF method, we are giving the weight each word. Okay, in this case, we are giving the weight to each word. These are the words, for example, I am going office. Okay, so and that is word WI in the document by the J by the TF-IDF. Okay, so weight for the word WI is equal to TF-IG into IDFI. Right. So, how this formula is work, we will see in the next. Right. So, just keep in mind that in here, we first, in the first method, we have to find the weight of for the each word. How that word is important in your sentence. So, you can use the TF-IDF method. Using this TF-IDF method, you have to find out the weightage of that particular sentence, particular word. For example, the weight of this word. Sentence is nothing but the, let us consider 0.15. Then this word use is 0.13. Then silent having the word weight 0.9, like this. Okay. So every word, so every word in the sentence you have to give the weight. And for that you have to use the very popular and famous method, that is called the TF-IDF method. Then the second approach, in the second approach we have to use the topic signature. So, what is the topic signature? In topic signature, you have to choose the similar set of silent words specific to that domain. Okay, so here we are more concentrate on the domain of that particular document. So, that document is more related to the education. That document is more related to which domain? It is more related to the food domain. It is more related to the finance domain. It is more related to the tools and traveling domain. Okay, and on the basis of that domain, you have to choose the similar set of the silent word. Okay, so here also we are use the weight WI, that is the WI is the word I, equal to 1 if WI is specific term, usual and mutual information. So if you are getting some information from that particular word, okay, so you can indicate it as a 1, otherwise 0. Okay, for example, Sachin playing and cricket. So, cricket is a most important word, okay, it has a specific term, so you can say that the cricket is a 1. Okay, because playing is a common thing. You can play the cricket, you can play the football, you can play the chess and everything. So, in that case, cricket is a 1, so in this topic signature, that word cricket is playing an important role, okay, and you can term it as a 1. Based on the sentence, how we can find out? So, this is a formula to find out the weight of the sentence. So, once you find out the weight of each word, here you are finding out the weight of each word from this sentence. For example, choose is 0.13, sentence is 0.15, okay, this is also has some data, some weight, is also has some weight, it also has some weight, and it is also has some weight. So, weight for the sentence. Now, what is the weight of the sentence now? After all, in the paragraph, there are the n number of sentences. Okay. So, you have to find out the weight of each sentence. So, data center, there are the n number of sentences. Sentence 1, sentence 2, sentence 3, sentence n. So, there are n number of sentences you can find. And this weight S is equal to 1 divided by S mod into summation of W in belonging to S, weight of W. Okay, so this is simply, you have to find out the, this weight is nothing but the, this. Okay, so this WI means how many weight you have, so you can, according to that you can find out the weight of that particular sentence. So let us consider the weight of this sentence is after calculating this, it is gave 2.3, for example, it gets 1.8, it gets 3.5. Okay. So from this you can easily say that sentence number 2 and the sentence number 3 are more important as compared to the sentence number 2, because the sentence number 1 and the 3 are having the weight of 2.3 and the 3.5. So we can select this for this sentence and this sentence. Okay, so we are selecting the 2 sentences out of these 3, so their weight are greater as compared to the S2. But the next task is to, you have to keep that sentence in the proper ordering. Okay, so that is another task, that is our second task. Right, there is another approach we are used to find out the sentence, important sentence. Okay, so let us consider, and that approach is called as a graph based approach. Okay, so what is the graph based approach? Let us see this example. So here there is one text document. The computation is the process following a well defined model, and the computation can be seen as the purely physical phenomena. Okay, so let us consider this is a document, and in this document there are the these two statements we are just making. Now you have to make the some processing, and on this processing you have to find out the S1, S2, S3, S4 and Sn. So what is that S? S is indicating the sentence S1, sentence S2. So let us consider this is a sentence S1, this is a sentence S2, this is a sentence S3 and so on. Okay, so what we are doing, we have to find out the CFID. Okay. Now this TFID is a machine readable format. What is the use of TFID? The TFID is nothing but it is used by the machine to understand the importance of that particular word. Okay, so in the S1 there is a one word that is called as a computation. So this computation having the weight 0.1, then there is another word that is a process. So process having the TFID weight that is a 0.15 and so on. In the second statement, computation is 0.1 TFID, that is the weight of this computation. Then sin, here you can see the one word that is a sin. Sin is having the weight 0.05 and so on. Okay, and this TFID is useful for machine readable format. It is a machine readable format, and this TFID is nothing but the weight. So what exactly mean by the TFID? The TFID is stand for the term frequency inverse document frequency. Okay, so what is the TFID? It is a term frequency inverse document frequency. This is the technique to quantify the word in a set of document. We generally compute a score for each word. Here we have quantified the compute the each word's weight to signify its importance in the document and the corpus. So how this word is important for this document or in this corpus? So if you want to represent it, so that is called the TFID, that is a term frequency inverse document frequency. Okay. So using this TFID concept, you have to also find out this statement, in this statement, what is the weight of this word, what is the weight of this word, what is the weight of this word. If it is a stop word, so you have to remove it. Okay, you have to keep only those tokenized words, and after tokenization, if that word is more important in your statement or not. Okay, and according to that, you have to give the TFID, that is the weight of the weight to that particular word. Okay, and that technique is called the TFID. Now, so from this, what I am doing, once I am getting this data, that is the machine readable format data, so I have to draw the one graph, and in this graph you can see that statement S1 is related to the statement S2 and vice versa. Okay, so that's why you look at this. Okay. So statement 1 is related to the statement S2, S2 is related S3, and this is making one of the closed graph. Okay, so which statement is related to which statement? Okay, so S3 is related to Fi, Fi is related to Sj, S1 if it is possible. Okay, and if it is a j, so it is also related to the j. So from this processing, we are getting this matrix, and from this we are getting the one graph to represent the document. Okay, and in this case, yes, the sentences that are convey the theme of the document are more similar to each other. Okay, so what is the concept behind this statement? Sentence that convey the theme of the document are more similar to each other. So every document, okay, you can see in the network or in the website also or anywhere, each paragraph or each paragraph having a particular theme. Okay, whenever you are finding the one article, maybe in the research paper article or in the web page article, so that web page article, that research based article are based on their theme only. Okay, they are based on the theme only. Okay, and every sentence that convey the theme of that document. So let us consider that document is related to the sport. So this is the theme of that particular document. If it is related to the healthcare, so that is the theme of that particular document. Okay, and this sentence is important. So how we can find out the importance of the sentence? So here we are using the concept called as the page ranking. Okay, so in the page ranking statement, page ranking also we have to find out the importance of the page. So the same concept we are use here, that is a sentence is important if many important sentences are similar to that particular sentence. Okay, so if we are finding out such a sentence that is more, that is more important if many sentences are similar to that particular sentence, so we can say that that sentence is important. Okay, so this page rank approach, we have to use the some page rank approach, and this is very important page rank approach. So how we can find out the page rank approach? So finding the most silent sentence, finding the most silent sentence from your document. So what I am doing here, I am making the this vertices S1, S2, S3, S4 and S5. So these are the vertices. Okay, so these are the sentences, and the sentences are represented as the vertices in the in this graph. And from this graph, I am making the one cosine similarity matrix. Okay, so this is the M tilde, right? So this M is represent the cosine similarity matrix. So let us consider S1 and S2 are more similar. S2 and S4 are more similar. S3 and S4 are more similar. So you have to find out the similarity. You have to calculate the sentence similarity function is used to calculate the age weight. So this page rank based algorithm is used to compute the sentence centrality vector. Okay, from this cosine similarity matrix, we have to next find out the sentence centrality vector, that is represented by the I. Okay, and this is the formula of sentence centrality vector I. Okay, and how it is work? Let us see this. First, tell me it is visible or not? Is it audible, class? Can someone